Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Policenauts, blind for the Sega Saturn. I am Amethyst Lunatari. I want to save my game. Been a while. New file, please. Okay, we'll go back. Okay, we can walk away. Go to lobby. We've been there. Vice. We've been there. Forensics is our next place to go. But what if we just hit walk away? See you later. So we can look at this room. Okay, that's what I wanted to do. Look at these guys. This looks like the same guy that we saw on the plane. The space plane. It is, then. He's the only one without a helmet on.
AP だったのか? Tony Redwood. AP の爆弾処理を担当してるが、エンプス乗りでは彼の右に出る者はいない。ミスター・ゴダードと呼ばれている。
宇宙酔いくらいで参るようじゃ、早くホームのママのところへ帰った方がいいぜ。それとも、またスチュワーデスに薬でももらうか。
Not very nice.
ここはビヨンドだ。あんたのような古いテレストリアルには厳しいところだ。
俺はお前のようにゾンビみたいになるつもりはないがね。
Oops.
ジョナサン、やめろ。相手にするな。
そうだ、エド。この次元装置の仕掛けわかるか。
なんだ、いきなり。
あんた、ホームで爆弾処理班にいたことがあるらしいな。
麻薬界入る前のことだ。
通常爆弾の設計者は解体されないようにいくつかの安全策を設ける。ここに赤と青のコードがあるだろう。
Mm-hmm.
最後のセーフティー装置だ。このどちらかを切断すれば解体できる。俺がセットしたとしたら、これはどっちだと思う？危険の赤か、
Green.
安全の青か。
レッドウッドのレッド。
は。
どうか、アウトだ。コロニーに穴が開いたぞ。攻撃的な人間が常に赤を好むとは限らない。
Fortunately, Red was still alive.
答えは青だ。俺ならいつも青にする。
ああ、覚えておくよ。
A little aggressive, this guy, isn't he? I'm gonna look around at various stuff. It kind of looks like a big bullet. Okay, look at that. These terminals display the data sent here but around the clock by the operators. The guy's in the lobby, right? Ed says these terminals output data on Beyond. What's this thing? Same. Alright, same. 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 That's an AP chair, it says. It's designed so they can keep their body armor on while they sit down. Well, why are they gonna have their body armor on if they're just sitting around an office? Or a lab, or whatever, in case they blow something up? Real bomb? No time for breaks around this place, Jonathan says. They're always on standby, ready to act at a moment's notice. I guess so. It's a chair for APs. It has a built-in chaos system that supports virtually every part of their body, including any injuries. Really? A massage chair for the 21st century, huh? Let's see this bomb here. I defused this earlier. Real state-of-the-art device. Ed says terrorists have been using some pretty advanced components in their bombs lately, haven't they? Jonathan says it was a bomb that killed Lorraine. Why'd you ask me about it anyway? Redwood says you never know when terrorists could strike. Even an old-timer like you should be prepared. Ed says, I don't ever want to have to defuse another bomb. You never know when you might have to deal with one of these. What do you think you're doing here? I'm not here to amuse you. That's BCP's holographic insignia, Ed says. In addition to identifying the wearer as a police officer, it's also there to prevent counterfeiting. Johnson says who'd believe he's one of the good guys without the uniform. Plus he's the only one without a helmet on, thus leaving his hair visible so we could recognize him. Redwood says, if you don't have a reason to be here, then beat it. What a weird vibe. You never guess he's a cop, Jonathan says. Ed says, even among APs, he's unusual. How'd you like to have him for backup? Beat it, huh? He's like a corpse with that complexion, not to mention the look on his face. We call them the living dead around the station, Ed says. I don't blame you. He's just standing right here. He can hear us. All he needs to do is moan, brains, brains, to complete the image, Jonathan says. Okay, what about the hair? Got anything to say about that? You don't see many people with long hair around here, especially magenta long hair. All Frozeners have long hair, Ed says. They don't like to cut it for some reason. Frozeners seem to like their hair long. I wonder why. Are you two trying to annoy me? Yeah. Trying, getting the results we want. Got a minute, Redwood? What do you want? Ask about himself. My commanding officer is the chief. My compatriots are the guys you see around you. You're neither of those. I don't have to answer your questions. Jeez. You're like the little dog that won't stop barking at your ankles. Go show him around Kabuki Quarter. It's right up his alley. What's he talking about? Ed says. Damn you, Jonathan says. Nothing, forget it. I'll say it again. I'm not obligated to talk to either of you. Would you please leave already? The odor is distracting. Oh, Jonathan says, I love you too, Smegma man. What? Oh my god. AP. I'll have to talk to anyone outside AP. That includes you, Ed. Jonathan says he's a totally different person from the plane. That, in case it hasn't hit you, that was an act. What? We can modify our personalities anytime we need to. Well, I can act without modifying my personality. All part of our training. Well, why? Lorraine's murder. Lorraine? Who's that? Don't know anyone called Lorraine. He really is like a completely different person, Jonathan says. Not my department. I don't know anything. Space plane. On a space plane, you said you'd gone to visit some family on home or something, didn't you? It wasn't work-related. It was personal. I'll have to explain myself to you. Answer the question. I don't remember saying anything like that. Speaking of the space plane, you should have seen this guy. He was feeling up one of the stewardesses. That true, Jonathan? Ed says. No, of course not. Redwood says, you will take him to Kabuki Quarter, yes? That your next stop? The hell you talking about, Ed says. Why would we go to a place like that? Whatever. See if I care. Jonathan says, what I wouldn't give for a couple minutes alone with this guy. What'd you come here for, anyway? Alright, well, it doesn't say much about anything. Let's show him the Hojo photo. Who are they supposed to be? I told you on the plane. I don't know them. You came all the way here just to look for those two? What a joke. Do I look like I want to see that? Lorraine's photo. I saw it on the plane. That's cute. Real cute. Cherish your memories, as they say, right? I couldn't care less about your photos. Frozeners don't need drugs. Those weren't for SAS after all? How about the leaf? You still got that? What are you carrying around something like that around for? Let's show them the Policenauts photo. Even if you were Policenauts, that was a long time ago. Look at you. A pair of sad old men. Jonathan says, you knew I was a police knot, didn't you? Sure. I've studied my ancient history. Funny. Real funny. That's what the police knots are around here. Right? Astronaut Brown? Anyone could go to space now. But it's frozeners who protect it. We are an adaptive species. Alright, we're done with this guy.
その加えタバコ、まだやめられないようだな。
Oh, observant.
そんな格好でうろうろしてると、逮捕されるぜ。
Uh-huh.
あいにく灰皿が見当たらんのでな。
灰皿？灰皿なら、空気感あるだろう。
Mm. What a jerk. We were supposed to be leaving. That's a body armor spacesuit APs use, Ed says. It can take quite a number of hits. If they have their helmet on, they can go out into space just like that. AP's body armor. You guys don't know when to shut up, do you? Alright, never mind. Walk away.
感じ悪いやつだな。一度も瞬きしなかった。
Mm. フローズナーはみんなだ。あれでノーマルらしい。
ノーマル？異常だぜ。
彼らは目に人工水晶体の眼内レンズを装着してるらしい。視力は常人の2倍はあるって聞いたがな。
あいつらが俺たちの子供かもしれんなんてな。
心配はいらん。少なくとも俺とジョナサンの精子は使われていないだろう。
だろうな。エドが遺伝的に優れてるなんて。
お前は宇宙恐怖症だしな。
それにしてもエド、ヤツに対しておかしくないか。
そうか。
ヤツと何かあるのか。
I would blame him.
ローズナーとは合わないだけだ。
Don't get along well with frozeners. It's a chair for APs. He's an AP officer. They can access any sort of data on Beyond from these terminals. That's what Ed says. Jonathan says, I guess the days of hitting the streets for leads are over, huh? Yeah, you can do it all from here. What's that thing there? That tube in their arm? It's part of the dialysis procedure for their artificial blood. You have to go undergo dialysis every 240 hours with that type of blood. Okay, so every 10 days then. Human kidneys can't filter it. Must be a pain in the ass, Jonathan says. 240 hours is 10 days. Meaning they could never go AWOL, huh? Exactly. Some people say they designed it that way. This takes up a bigger slice of BCP's annual budget than you'd think. Yeah. Redwood was telling me how expensive dialysis is. I think he was exaggerating a tad, though. An AP unit member. They're APs, the next generation of space police. How about this display here? These terminals output data on Beyond. That's also an AP. That's the hangar for AP's EMPS behind the chief. Our medicals and system engineers are all employees of Tokugawa Heavy Industries. It's the EMPS hangar. They look like they came straight out of those robot animes that were big when we were kids. All the Gundam ones. Gotta look at him without zooming in. That's Gates, the head honcho. It's the chief. Okay, I guess there's nothing else to look at. Let's go to forensics.
Yo, Doctor Sensei.
How's it hanging?
Edo,
わしはビクトルじゃ。いつになったらちゃんと呼んでくれるんじゃ。
Look at this plane.
諦めた方がいい。エドは物覚えが悪いんだ。
お、誰じゃね、その人は。
ジョナサン、紹介するよ。BCP の鑑識を担当しているビクトル・ユルゲンス先生だ。
よろしく、ジョナサン・イングなんだ。OLA で探偵をしている。
ほう、あんたがあの有名なイングラム飛行士？え？
He remembers.
若い頃、あんたの火星有人飛行の中継をワクワクして見ていたよ。そうか、戻ってきたんじゃな、あんたのホームに。よろしくな。
Well, he is impressed. Now, what is this? What's this?Victor says, that's my aid analyzer. What you see on the monitor is a visual representation of the aid's AI. I named him Gorby. He responds to my voice. Gorby's mood is translated onto the screen. So what kind of mood is that? What's he based on? Or who is he based on? You? Nope. The last president of the Soviet Union. Oh, I get it.It's almost like he's alive in there. Alright, let's look around first before we talk to anybody. That's his keyboard. I use it for analyses. There are limits to his voice recognition capabilities. The keyboard comes out when you open this cover. That's where his keyboard is stored. It's Victor's forensic robot, the aide.About these things. These are his visual sensors. His eyes, so to speak. I say eyes, but they're just for moving around. He doesn't use them in analyses. He can move around? Those are his eyes. He might recognize you if you're lucky. So this is also an eye? Anything here in the corner? No. What is this? That's his arm.The hand contains sensors made out of materials like pressure-sensitive rubber and conductive silicon rubber. Okay, I see that's his arm. Okay, I thought there was something behind and to the side. It allows him to determine the shape and composition of the object he's analyzing. That's his arm. Don't expect a handshake. What's on these bookshelves? Them?Old books on anatomy and pathology. I brought them with me from home. You still use them? Of course not. I get all my information online. Nobody uses antique media like those anymore. So they're like mementos? I suppose. I could never bring myself to throw them away. I bet you know the feeling, don't you? Yep. They're medical texts from the 20th century. Same as these, yeah.Where's this? It's Russia, the old Soviet Union, I should say. That's where I'm from. Been about 50 years since the last time I was there. It's Russia, Dr. Jurgen's home country. I wonder what it's like now, Victor says. I have to go back at least once before I kick the bucket. Jonathan says it's a lot different from when you were a kid. They had a complete economic recovery, too. About these memos...That, my friends, is a clipping of the thesis. Of a thesis, to be specific, the thesis. It was in this famous academic journal on home. I decided to major in pathology after I read it. That paper changed my life forever. I wonder what it's about. Well, that paper as well changed his life forever. Good to know. This chair looks prehistoric. I don't like the chairs APs use.I know they're ergonomically designed and supposedly won't give you sore legs or a sore back, no matter how long you use them, but they just don't sit well with me. I prefer this kind of chair. Too bad they don't sell those anymore. The field of ergonomics is still lacking when it comes to research into the mental aspects. Okay, more stuff. Light.This is some amazing equipment you've got. Amazing? Think so? Johnson says, well, amazing in the sense that they're all ancient analog devices. I've had these a long time. I still use them in my research. To be honest, I use aid for most of my work. So they're more of a collection? You could say that. I have a lot of memories of these. I bought most of them myself. If you don't know your equipment inside out, you'll end up missing something important eventually. Those kids in AP think they're a bunch of junk, but digital equipment isn't perfect. So this takes place. This pertains to all of this stuff then. Got these notes. Those pieces of paper have chemical formulas for transferases on them. I'm not familiar with that word. I discovered them myself, not that long ago either. You're still using paper? Writing out ring structures is complicated stuff. It takes longer trying to do them on computer. I don't like to waste any of my time. It's a piece of paper with chemical formulas on it. Same here. Same. And same. Is that your ID? Yeah, I don't like my hologram, so I've got this sticker over it. It causes problems with the readers whenever I have to scan it. It's Victor's ID card, Ed says. There's a sticker on top of his photo. That picture's terrible. I had to cover it up. Benz? There's blood on your clothes. I should think so. I've had this gown since my first autopsy. It holds the blood of every single body I've looked at over the years. Oh, jeez. Guess you could say a piece of their souls, too. Oh, no. Will souls come out in the wash? It's Victor's medical gown. It looks a lot more like military camouflage. Victor says any fresh blood that gets on it blends right in. My God. You got some kind of armband or something here? Is that armband a mark of respect? Yeah, it's a crepe. It's for all the dissidents I work with. Ed says Victor wears that armband every day. Every day. But your glasses. I haven't seen many people with glasses here. I like glasses. They have a certain je ne sais quoi. When I was younger, I would change mine whenever something big happened in my life. What would you do if they broke while you're in a weightless area? This pair is made from an unbreakable polymer. Besides, I hardly ever go to zero gravity areas anyway. Gray hair. You combed your hair today, Victor? It's sticking up at the back. Sticking up? That's all you can say? What about, that's some pretty thick hair you got there, Victor. Every hair on my head is mine. Not bad, eh, hon? Yeah, not bad. I think you're set for life at this point, Victor, Jonathan says. Victor's hair never looks any different, Ed says. So should I talk to him first or talk to this? Let's talk to this. Hey, Gorby. I wouldn't bother, Victor says. He's an AI, up to a point. He can tell you what's in the dirt on your shoes, but he can't talk. Just blips and bleeps. Ah, how disappointing. How's life, Gorby? He's processing something right now, actually. Sometimes I'm glad he can't talk. Probably wouldn't shut up. Alright, we'll talk to Victor. Victor? I'm listening. Asking about himself. Are you a terrestrial? You'd have to be at your age, wouldn't you? I was born in Moscow, back when socialists ran the country. That picture was taken around the time I was born. After the collapse of the Soviet Union, I went to America to study forensic medicine and later became a medical examiner. I've done autopsies on over 30,000 bodies throughout my career. Seriously? 30,000 bodies. So for that'd be 30,000 bodies? That'd be like multiple bodies a day. 3,000 every... never mind. I don't know how long his career has been, but yeah, even at his age, that 30,000, that's insane. In my 40s, I became interested in studying bodies in space and came here. You should see the bodies you get in zero gravity. The decomposition stages are freaky stuff. That's alright. Why'd you become a forensic pathologist? Doctors deal with the living. There's always the possibility they'll screw up and kill the guy. You can't kill someone if they're already dead, can you? Forensic medicine is less stressful than regular medicine, wouldn't you say? That's nasty, though. I've done this my whole life. I don't really have any other interests. I probably seem like some narrow-minded old fool to you guys. No, you're not, Victor. Jonathan says, you're perfectly normal. You're just being yourself. I know how that is. Thanks. Maybe you and I have more in common than we think. His job. My area of expertise is medical examinations, but with my aid, I can perform most other analyses, too. AP has its own science team, so we're on a shoestring budget here. It's just Gorby and me. The further computer analyses progress, the less use there is for people like me. Finally, AP gets most of the real work. I hardly ever get to do anything. Or frankly, not finally, sorry guys. I'm still just as good as any of them. All they ever do is throw things in their fancy schmancy analyzers. Jonathan says, you sound just like Marilyn Dave. None of you guys are fans of AP. There's no substitute for experience when it comes to this stuff. I bet you could outperform their supercomputers. No damn quantum flux parametrons are going to outsmart me. So what if they got ultra-high-speed logic elements? They might be good at crunching numbers, but they can't think outside their box. How could they react to new types of cases? That's the thing. They couldn't. The most important thing in forensics is a good imagination. Could you tell me more about that AID doohickey? AID is short for Auto Analysis Identification Device. It's an AI gadget for doing analyses. It's got a number of sensors like a spectrograph, a gas chromatograph, and a geotechnical sounder. You make it yourself? Ha! Are you kidding? I wouldn't even know where to start. AID and its analysis programs are created by this guy on Home. He's a big help around here. He's a whiz when it comes to analyses. Doesn't make for much company, though. Hojo's disappearance. I'm actually here looking for a missing person. Supposing he's already dead, how possible would it be to transport his body outside the colony? You could never take a body outside beyond single-handedly. They've got a pretty tight security system in place. It would be easier to transport them out while they're still alive and kill them somewhere else. They're becoming stricter and stricter about space debris every year. What about getting rid of a body inside the colony? Say the person had been dead for several weeks. Burning it would attract too much attention. Dumping it underwater wouldn't work either. They detect the gases released during decomposition. Well, it's kind of crude, but burying it might be the best way. The colony has several meters of soil in its surface areas to help protect against cosmic rays. You wouldn't smell it if it was buried at least 20 to 30 centimeters down. So we're gonna go digging somewhere. In any case, you can never hide a body or get it out without help from the Mafia. There's a Mafia here? You have any leads or anything? Jonathan says, I have a few things belonging to him. Let me take a look at them. Show me those things you were talking about. Okay, here's the photo. Who are these guys? They look Japanese. This is Kenzo Hojo, the man who's disappeared. This is the guy you're looking for? Anyone who wears glasses here has to be a terrestrial. Lorraine's photo. Oh? Who's this? What are you talking about? That's me. Not you. I meant the fox next to you. You could call it an old memory. A really old memory. That's what I expect from a terrestrial. Beyonds don't look back on the past the way we do. Maybe you understand what that picture means to me. I do. Cherish your memories, Jonathan. Okay, before I start getting into forensics analysis, let's look, show him the Policenauts photo. I still remember it. That famous picture. Look at you. We all thought you guys were incredible. Ed says, you never told me that before. Really? Well, now you know. It was a nice time, wasn't it? Full of romance. Alright, show him the capsules.
Victor, 調べてもらいたいものがあるんだ。
おお、なんじゃ、それか。
あ、これもそうだが、もう一つある。
全部見せてみ。
うん。Capsules and a leaf? Victor says. Can you do it? I could never turn down a request from one of the Policenauts, could I? Ed says, this stays between us, okay, Doctor? Give me a little time. Shouldn't take too long. Thanks, Victor. No problem. I'll get started right away. Okay, he has the stuff. Okay, I guess we gotta leave and come back, and then he'll have a result for us. I thought we'd have some cool little animated segment of stuff being analyzed and stuff. But I guess not. So thanks so much for watching. See you guys in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.